its derivatives and the application. The application
Well,
is there. Let me check again, just a second. I think it's the higher derivatives and let me check, just give me a few seconds. I'm not sharing my
okay.
screen, right?
No, you're not.
All right. I did not set this because I went on leave last year. I only came back in March. So everything was set already.
Oh, okay. Because like under the assignments, it's not
But
stated what is covered. That's why I'm asking.
okay, because I noticed in some assignment she did not follow the assignment hints. So I'll have to check. Assignment two, right?
Yes.
See. Just a second. Differentiate, differentiate, differentiates on derivative, derivative, differentiates. If then the derivative, find the second derivative. Oh, okay. I think up to we have 11 questions on the derivatives, like finding the first order up to the higher order.
Okay.
Then we do have the application where you are asked for critical points.
Okay, thank
The
you.
interval where the function is increasing or decreasing, or finding the slope, you know, that's derivative.
Yes. Oh, okay,
Find
thank
the
you.
stationary points. It's, yeah. So it's that lesson 4 + 5, sum.
Oh, okay.
See what
Okay,
does
thank you.
this. Problem.
Hi, Miss Ngomo.
Yes, hi.
I just wanted to ask. So I haven't attempted actually any assignments at all since I was practicing and trying to catch up, but then I'm ready now and about to do so. But then I wanted to ask, now that you're saying assignment two is based on lesson 4 and 5, I wanted to know about then what is assignment one based on, since that is that a, I don't know, that paper that shows, I forgot the name of the paper about the module. It says that assignment one is based on lesson 1 until 5.
Assignment one. It's 1, 2, 3.
Oh, just 1, 2, and 3. Yeah.
Yes.
You know, that's why it took such a long time trying to. I thought it's 1 to 5, but thank you so much.
No problem.
Hi, ma'am. How are you?
I'm okay. How are you?
I'm also good. Ma'am, I'm asking, is it compulsory to write assignment 5? Because I wrote all my assignments. Is it compulsory?
Yes, assignment also contribute. Okay, assignment 1 to 5, they all contribute 20% each. Ne? And then that
Yes.
20% towards the final mark for all the assignments, it becomes 20%. So if you don't write assignment five, let's say you get 100% for all the assignments, that means you have 80%, because also assignment five contributes 20%.
Yes.
And another thing, I wouldn't advise you guys to leave assignment five, because assignment five, it helps you in like, it will help you understand the scope or the structure of the exam, because they cover the same sections, and they are both timed, because assignment five is it 2 hours 30 minutes? Even the exam is 2 hours 30 minutes. Even though assignment five, do you have two attempts? Okay, but for exam you have one attempt. I'll still have to check for assignment five if there are two or one attempts. But they are both timed, even though assignment five will open for 5 days and exam will open for 1 day. But when it comes to the structure, it's more or less the same thing. So assignment five is there to prepare you for the exam, and it also contributes towards your DP and the final mark.
Okay.
And again, you guys, you need to make sure you do assignment one, because if you don't do assignment one, you won't qualify to write the exam. You won't have access to write the exam. Even though all the assignments, they contribute the same percentage, but assignment five, but you need to do assignment one. Assignment one is compulsory, because it gives you access to what's the exam. So even if you get 100% for other assignments, if you don't do assignment one, you won't be able to write the exam.
Okay, thank you, ma'am.
Ma'am, can you please brief me about the exam? Like, the exam, how do you log in? How do you write the exam? Like, I'm blind on that, and I think I'm going to need that information.
Okay. For exam, you see, on the welcome page right now, the welcome page that you have, where I like introduce you to this module, or I welcome you to this module. Before the exam, we'll change the welcome page, and the welcome page will contain the exam, the link to the exam, right? Okay, so you can just go to Moodle on the welcome page and click on that link. It will take you straight to my exams, where you'll write the exam. Okay, here's the thing about the exam, similar to assignment five, you need to make sure that you write with a device that has a camera. You won't have access to the exam or assignment five if the device that we are using to write both assignment five and the exam doesn't have a camera. And another thing, guys, you need to make sure that you do not close your screen, because if your screen is blank, then you'll be sent for disciplinary hearing, and that could take even a year. So if you are sent for disciplinary hearing, you won't be able to register for other modules. You have to wait until you are called for that disciplinary hearing. Yeah? And another thing, since since you need a device with a camera, that means on my exam, we have a tool that will keep on taking your pictures while you are writing. It's okay, you can face down. We know you'll have to calculate your writing maths. You won't be penalized for that. Ne? Yes. It's okay.
Can you repeat that?
I said you'll have to do the calculation. You'll face down. You'll face the camera. You'll write down. It's fine.
Wait, I mean, like, Sorry, wait, hold on. I mean, like before the camera part, what did you say about the camera? Regarding the camera, you said you have a too long way?
I said?
You said yeah, there's a too far.
Oh, I said there is a tool on my exams and also on Moodle that will keep on taking your pictures. That's called okay. Moodle Proctoring. It's a Moodle Proctoring tool. You don't have to install anything. We are not using, what is this app that's, we are not using the Invigilator app.
Okay.
We are not using it. So there will be no passwords that you'll require to access the exam. Since you are using Moodle Proctoring, what you need to do is you need to have a device that has a camera. Ne?
Or like a webcam or something like that. Ne?
Yes.
Okay.
And make sure your camera is working, because if it's blank, you'll be penalized for that. And if we see that there's someone showing in the camera, you'll be penalized for that. But if it's a kid passing by, it's fine. And you are writing an open book, so have your study guide with you. You can open your apps. I know you are using apps for maths. It's fine. You can use them. As long as I don't see someone helping you. Ne? And another thing, there are contractors who writes for you. Like, there'll be people approaching you guys saying for you to pass the module, they can write for you. Okay, I'm trying to show you guys the reports that we had where, like, same person was writing, same contractor was writing for different students. So we'll see a person showing on a username A and on a username 2, something like that. Okay, I want to show you just a second. Maybe I did that reporting. May-June.
Okay, wait, I just want to ask a question.
Yes.
Let's say you don't have like a web. Cam, for example, you said that this Moodle proctoring tool, is that what we use for the exam?
Pardon?
Let's say we don't have a webcam, right, or a device that has a camera, right? This yes. Moodle proctoring tool, do we use that as our camera in the exam, for the exam?
No, you use your device as the camera. Oh. It's just okay. That Moodle Proctoring tool will access the pictures, will take the pictures from your device.
Oh, okay.
Like your device will keep on taking the pictures for your pictures, but it will save those pictures okay. on Moodle Proctoring tool, not on your phone.
Okay, so thing you do is just to log into that the email, the link.
Yes, you just have to log in on the link. Okay, can you see my screen?
Yeah.
Yes, okay. Yes.
You see, we have this person, it's Tim Sile. You see, this person is the same as this one, Sanele. And you see, there is this person again writing for another one.
Okay, the screen is blank, Ms. Ngomo.
So if someone approaches you and wants to write for you, do not agree, because they're not just writing for you, they're writing for different people. And if the screen is blank, you see, if the screen is blank too, you'll be penalized, you'll be sent for disciplinary hearing again. And so I know some of you, they will write using the device with the camera and put something on their screen so that we won't see that maybe two people or they are writing the exam as a group. Since we've noticed that you guys use that trick, so if the screen is blank, again, you won't receive your marks. You'll be sent for disciplinary hearing.
But ma'am, how am I going to know if my screen is blank or what. Are they going to give us instructions or like, I'm blind. I don't know anything. I'm a new student. Please just be patient with me and explain to me.
You're not alone, Palette. I'm 16. So, Miss Nkomo.
Usually, before the exam,
I have to download. Yes,
you can continue.
Okay, usually before the exam, there will be a link shared under additional resources. That link has a makeup exam. That makeup exam will prepare you on how to use them, on how the multi-proctoring tool works. So you need to access, log in on that link. You'll be asked general questions. It's not for marks, it's just there to help you on the multi-proctoring tool thing. Practice on it. Okay, it won't even take you more than 5 minutes on that link. Then you'll see that your camera is blank.
That means I can write using my phone, like just to log on that link. Then I'm using my phone really for writing. Then you're going to see everything through like one cell phone, or I'm going to need a laptop or two cell phones or something.
Just one device. Because if you log on different devices, if you open the exam, I'm sorry. If you log on different devices, then you'll be kicked out from the exam. If maybe you wrote one question and logged on different devices, it will be like you answered one question throughout the whole exam, because it will submit your attempt automatically. And then, so just make sure you log in on one device. If you are using a phone, do not use a laptop. If you are using your laptop, do not use a phone. Okay, and another thing, I know sometimes you put your phone down when you're calculating it. It's still fine. Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Okay, so the exam is an open book, ne?
Yes.
Okay, man. It's not that bad.
It's not that bad. If you do on the assignments and the examples on the study guide, you can even get 100. There's no way.
Hello, Ms. Nkomo.
Yes, hi.
There's no way that we can download previous question papers for better preparation.
God, I always wanted to know, ma'am. Because I'm only using YouTube and my study guide. I don't have the previous question papers.
You don't need previous question papers.
Ma'am, but we need to see like how are the questions being set up?
It's the same as assignments. And the same as...
We need to play around different questions, ma'am. In case in the exam, a question comes like this, like I'm not going to be surprised. This is not the first question. Like, this is not the first time I attempt something like this. You see? I think we need previous question papers.
Yes, ma'am, because previous question papers, they really help a lot just to know the structure of the exam paper.
The past papers, are they not there on Moodle?
No, I didn't see them. Where on Moodle?
Under additional resources.
No, they are not there.
Okay, I will upload the one that I have, the ones that I have there. But trust me, you do not need them. You'll see that they are completely different compared to, you know. Yeah, but you can use them as extra practice. And again, I'm still going to give you extra exercises.
Yeah.
But as for the exams, yeah, past exams, you can use them if you want to. You can work on them, but I don't have solutions. Please do not ask me for solutions. I was not there when someone was teaching around that year. I don't have access to the solutions. I only have access to my solutions, the one that I'm using. I can't be setting or like the same thing every year. So that's one of the reasons why I don't have past papers. And whenever I set, I use the study guide.
Please upload as many as possible, Ms. Bom.
I think I only have 3 or 4.
So, ma'am.
And I only started teaching this module in 2021. So you won't have exam paper for 2021, 2022, 2023. And this
year. So, ma'am, who's going to set the exam?
The exam is set already.
By you?
Prof set some of the questions, but they were not enough. I had to add on them.
Okay, so the only advice you can give us is to redo the assignment and stick on the study guide. Are you
stick on the study guides? Do the examples, do the exercises on the study guide. Redo the assignments. I will give you the solutions. Make sure you understand. You will have a revision before the exam. Make sure you ask questions if you have questions. As for past papers, yes.
Yes. When is the exam? Like the date?
Okay. I don't want you guys to come back and fight me, ne? But for now, the exam is on the 8th. Yes, I think it's on the 8th. Ne? The reason I'm saying I don't want you guys to come back and fight me is because usually this module is always, they always write this module in May, at the end of May. But this time the module, they said it's in June. Let me see. Let me check the timetable. It's in June. And this timetable can change, ne?
Okay.
Make sure you check timetable. You check your timetable, because once it's sent to you guys, then they won't change it. But for now, since they've sent it to just us, they can still change it, ne? Let me check the date for now. They said the date is the 5th of June. So if you guys don't write on the 5th of June, do not come back and fight me, because they can still change the timetable. But if they don't change it, yes, you'll write on the 5th of June.
Okay, can I ask
from
me,
8th.
What time?
From 8 until 10:30.
Okay.
And then where do we find the timetable? The timetables, because I've been looking everywhere, I don't see it.
I'm not sure. How do you check as a student? Because my module and your module are different, ne? But it's there on Moodle.
On Moodle.
For me, if I check the timetable, I can check on Moodle, ne?
Okay. Is it possible if you could send us the exam timetable on the announcements, unless we find them for ourselves?
I don't want to send it just in case they change it, ne? But as soon as I know this is the final timetable, I'll communicate with you via announcement.
Okay, ma'am, thank you.
Ma'am, can I ask something? So since the exam will be only open for like 2.5 hours, did they take into consideration that sometimes, like when a lot of people log in and try to access like assignments, I don't know, my UNISA just X out. So if it's only like 8 to 9:30.
You'll be writing on a different site, my exam.
Oh, applied form. Okay, that's better.
They do know how many modules are written in that day. And again, guys, if you know you have low shedding, please make means that you travel or you go to internet cafe, because they don't take that excuse. They said it's beyond us. Like, low shedding is here to stay. You need to like live around, to plan around it. So if you have network issues, there's noise.
People walking around. I'm saying in the internet cafe, there is noise. The people walking around, yeah. So there will be penalties for that.
It's in the corner, if there's a corner. You know, because even try and go to my... Do we have lens in UNISA?
I don't know.
So, ma'am, I also saw in the tutorial letter about examinations that there must not be voices heard on the device.
Remember, I said we are not using the MOOC. We are not using the Invigilator app. Invigilator app tracks the noise, but MOOC processing take pictures. So I won't hear what you are saying if you guys are discussing. But if I see that there are two people on the picture, showing on the picture, then I can penalize you. Oh. Even if it's your mom, because I won't know it's your mom, they're asking you for something. Just because I see there are two people, then you'd be penalized. But if there is a kid, you won't be penalized. Yeah. So no voices, just pictures. Unless it's more advanced this year.
Makes sense.
Even if they are dogs. Yes.
Okay, ma'am, I have a question. Relating to higher derivative.
Yes.
I think there's a mistake, but obviously maybe it is that I don't understand something. It's lin x. I know that the first derivative is 1/x.
Mm-hmm.
Right? Yes. And then the second derivative, you have 2/x².
Minus 1/x².
Oh, yes, exactly. Yes. You have -2/x².
Mm-hmm. Okay. What is the first function? Mm-hmm.
What is that?
Wait. Let me write, ne? So that's our. Am I still sharing my screen? Can you see my screen now?
Yes, we can.
Okay. Please give me the initial function, the original function.
The original function is exponent 4.
Okay, just a second. My pen is not writing, doesn't want to write. Because she just contributes and buy me a new pen. I'm joking. All right, I'll try and write with my finger. F and X, is equal to
x exponent 4
x to the power 4.
Yes. Yeah.
X to the power 4. Just plus, give me the lead part.
Oh, okay. Plus 10x to the power 3 plus 2x plus e to the power x.
Just give me the parts that you have a problem with. I don't want you to give me the whole assignment question.
Oh, it's only lean x.
Okay. Let me say plus lean x. And okay, you are asked to find, let me subtract this part. You were asked to find the fourth.
Yes, the first until the fourth. It was an example that you did.
The first here would be 1 over x, right? We agree. Then the second.
I know this is gonna be.
I'm trying to write with my hand, with my finger. My pen doesn't want to write. Okay. The second here, remember, you are differentiating x to the power minus 1, right? We want to find the derivative of x to the power minus 1. So that means the derivative of this would be minus x minus 2, right? And this is the same thing as minus 1 over x squared, right? Then the third order derivative, 1, 2, 3. Okay, that means you want to find the derivative of minus 2, right? And the derivative of this would be 2x to the power minus 3, right?
Minus 3, ma'am.
Yes, minus 3, because you have minus 2 minus 1. That will give you minus 3.
Okay,
that is the third order. And this is the same thing as 2 over x to the power 3, right? And then the fourth order, 1, 2, 3, 4. Oh, 4. You want to find the derivative of 2x to the power minus 3, right? And that derivative would be minus 6x to the power minus 4. And this is the same thing as minus 6 over x to the power 4.
Yes, ma'am.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, yes. I think the solution, when you're doing the recording, the answer was wrong, but it's fine now.
The recording, maybe I divided with something, I don't know.
Yeah.
Because maybe in the function, there were terms with a common factor, maybe a common factor of 2, then I divide with 2 at the end. I don't know. I don't know which question you're talking about. But if you differentiate lean and you want to find the fourth order, that would be your answer. But maybe if we had other function and you need to simplify further, maybe you have a common factor or something like that.
Okay, no problem. Thank you very much, ma'am.
No problem.
Hello.
Yes, hi.
Ms. Nolozi, I was struggling with Moodle. I don't know how to log in into Moodle.
You don't, so you've never done any assignments?
I'm doing them on my... I'm using a laptop, so I go online straight to my module on my user.
On my unit, and then you go to more modules. You select this module, right? That's module.
Yes. Yeah.
That's module.
Oh, I thought maybe you have to download an app and stuff.
No, we are not downloading anything.
Oh, okay.
You can use it online.
Even for the exam, for the picture thing.
Yes, you just log in on that link. It will take you straight to my exams platform.
Okay. Thank you.
Hello, ma'am. Are you still there? Oh, we are done.
She's here. I'm just waiting for questions. If you don't have questions anymore, I will see you guys Monday. On Wednesday, I think I'll try and record. But yo, that section we're going to have on our next session. It's also very important. You need to master it, like the differentiation, because it's the inverse. So it's the inverse of the differentiation. It's easy to make mistakes once you know both sections, ne? Because, like, for example, ne? You have something like this with differentiation. If you are differentiating, say, x to the power n, you are asked to find the derivative of this. The answer, you'll take n here, you multiply with it, and then you subtract 1 from n. But as for that, that section will start. Let's say you are given x to the power n, and you are asked to find the integral of this. The integral of this would be, okay, first from n you add 1, so you'll have n plus 1, then you divide with 1 over n plus 1. You see, it's the inverse of this we are reversing. So once you know these two sections, it's easy to make mistakes. Yeah? So I think I'll need three classes to do this section again.
Okay, ma'am.
So I'm not sure whether I'll be able to record myself on Wednesday, because I won't be able to teach.